Hello everyone, this is Ilias from Your Workout. Today we're gonna do an upper body stretching workout for rounded shoulders. We're gonna do 3 sets and 5 exercises. We're gonna do 45 seconds each exercise and 50 seconds rest in between. But let's not waste time. Let's start. Hello everyone, we're about to start. We will start first with the dorsal stretch for the right side. Let's place the hand next to the door and let's start. You should feel the stretching here on the chest. It's very good because the tight chest muscles can cause this like the rounded shoulders. So first we have to stretch everything around here. Excellent. We're gonna do the same on the left side. Place the hand here. If you have a door or a handle at the level of the shoulder, it's also acceptable. Start. I stretch and turn the most to feel the stretching here on the chest. Next one will be the hand clasp behind your back. We're going to place both hands like this. We're going to try to keep the shoulders down. We don't want them to lift. And we're trying to lift them. And as you can see here, you can already feel that the chest, your chest will feel the stretching like this. I try to hold it there to the point that you feel the stretching. Don't try to force it, because if you try to force it, you will cause more harm because you will try to compensate the movement. So go until that point that you feel that the stretching starts and just keep it there. Of course, if you feel that you bent over, try to keep your core muscles flexed so you can avoid any compensation. And try to look in the front. Perfect. Next exercise will be the thoracic extensions on the couch. So here we are gonna sit in front of the couch, place the elbows on the couch, and you're trying to push the upper body towards the ground, your hips towards the back, and try not to do this lumbar extension, because we don't want that. Keep your core muscles and push down. You have to feel the stretch on your upper body, on the thoracic area. You can relax for a couple of seconds and push again. Try to keep the core muscles and your lower back straight. When you push down, try to push your hips towards the back. So you go down, your core muscles are tight, and you push towards the back. Next one will be the standing T-stretch. You're standing, extend your hands left and right like this and try to push them backwards like this, and you should feel the stretching here. It's also very effective if you're unable, or if your hands get tired and you just feel more your shoulder is working. You can do it on the mattress. You can lay like I did on the mattress and extend your hands like this. So you want your shoulders to touch the ground. Excellent. The next one will be the cat and dog. You're placing your hands at the level of your shoulders and your knees are at the level of your hips. And you're trying to do the cat and dog position, so the cat. And after you slowly go to the cat position, to the dog position. Try to keep each position when you go to the top, keep it for a couple of seconds. Slowly let go. Perfect. Now we're going to do the same exercises from the beginning. We're going to start again with the door chest stretching on the right side. Keep it at the level of the shoulder. Try not to move it front or back. And try to keep your hand here to feel any movement. Try to look in the front and try to turn. So you can start to feel the stretching here. We're going to do the same like before on the left side. And let's start. Try to turn. Keep your hand here. Try to not compensate with any other body movement. You have to feel the stretch on your chest. Try to concentrate on that. Try to keep your core muscles tight and strong so you don't make any other incorrect movement and the whole stress can focus perfectly on your chest. Again, we're going to do the hand clasp on the back. Try to grab your hands behind here. Try to slowly move them. Try not to make these movements, compensatory movements. Try to move your shoulders towards the back and try to lift it. And start to feel the first stretching, like I said before. Keep it in this position. Perfect. The next one, we're going to do the thoracic extensions on the couch, like before. Hips at the level of the knee, the elbows here. Push towards the ground, keep your core muscles tight. And when you push down, try also with your hips to push towards the back. You can relax a little bit. Let's go one more time. Push down. more time. Perfect. And the next one will be the Stasnik T-stretch that we did before. You can do it on the ground, as I said. The previous one, I made half and half. Right now, we'll make the standing one. Extend your hands and try to move them backwards. Try to look in the front and try also to keep your core muscles. This is very important. Keep your core muscles all the time tight to avoid any movement that can compensate because they're very tight. And move them backwards and keep them like this. Bring them back and try again. Don't make it too fast. We want slowly, we want to feel the stretch. Keep it for 5 to 10 seconds. And after you can slowly bring them in the front. We don't want fast movements. We don't want ballistic movements. Perfect. Again, right now we go back to do the position, the cat and dog. Hands at the level of the shoulders and knees at the level of the hips. And start. Keep each position, I would advise, for 5 seconds. When you're at the top, when you go here, 5 seconds here. Perfect. We're going to do from the beginning of the exercise one more time. Here on the door, we'll do the chest straightening on the right side. Like I said, try to stretch, try to turn without moving your shoulder to feel more and more. Since this is the third set, you will feel more relaxed. It will be easier for you. Perfect. We're going to do the same on the left side. Very important thing is to also not forget to breathe during the exercise, during the stretching. I know that you can get sometimes too concentrated and you forget to breathe, but it's very important to have the correct breathing. Perfect. We're going to do again the hand clasp on the back. Facing the front. Try to move your shoulders back. And try to lift your hands. Keep your core muscles strong. Your head look in the front. Don't make any compensatory movement. Don't forget to breathe. Try to avoid lifting your shoulders. It's better if you just reach the position that you feel first the stretch, even if it's a very small one, than if you lift them, because at the end you are just it's better the 5%. If you lift them, you literally stretch at zero. Perfect. We'll do thoracic extensions on the couch. One more time. Start. Try to push the upper body towards the ground. Keep your core muscles strong and tight. Let's relax a little bit. Let's go down one more time. Perfect. We'll do again the standing T-stretching. Let's move them back. Try to keep that position for a couple of seconds, 5 to 10 seconds. Let's move them in the front. Back to the end position. Perfect. And the last one that we have is the cat and dog. Let's start. That was the end of the stretching workout. And there you have it, everyone. That was the workout. I would advise you to do this workout for a week until you feel the pain relief. But after, please slowly try to also strengthen your back, because the combination of stretching and strengthening together will fix your rounded shoulder problem forever. If you like my video, please drop a like and also subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell to never miss a video that I upload. Thank you so much for watching and stretching with me. And I will see you in the next workout.